and Cam and a Super George. Look at Buddy, hotter, hot and large. She's a hot rod. She's a hot rod. She's my hotter.
AM 1420 WIMS, Talk of the South Shore. Star VIP Hotline, this hour brought to you by Unlimited Service. And I want to throw this out there. So this morning, as I was making my way into the radio station, I was hungry, but I said I'm not going to eat because I don't want it to sit in my stomach for 100 miles. So I made eggs. I made 6 eggs. I split them between myself, Norma, and Carly. Had 3 little containers. Turkey sausage. Everybody gets one. I cut it up and throw it in there. But this is where it gets good. Not only did I season the eggs, Big George, and not only did I throw the sausage in there, but I threw on top of that and gave it a little Ric Federighi shake, Mama Romero's homemade hot salsa. And dude ball, I just scarfed some of those eggs during WIMS Sports. Woo! Man, it just burning fire, baby. Burning fire!
You're gonna get a sympathy card from your stomach. You know that.
I know.
Whoa! Woo! Jeez, that fire, that stuff will burn you alive.
Well, you know, but it's fresh, it's homemade, and it's mama. You know what I mean? She makes I'm telling you, George. She makes tamales in the corn husk. She makes fresh mole. She makes the best salsas, the best homemade Mexican soups. Dude, I just love eating her food. She's been teaching Norm and I for a number of years some of the different recipes. But man, this salsa, I could eat salsa like no other. I am like the Mexican that, you know, the wannabe. Because
we do a lot of Hispanic food here at our house. Plus, we go out a lot to different restaurants. That's the kind of food we really like. I've been to Mexico 25 or 30 times. I'm hooked on the food, believe me.
Yep, I am so with you. Well, speaking of being hooked on great things, Big George the Carguy, Saturday mornings, 10 a.m. right here on WIMS, 11 a.m. on WHFB. You got several ways to listen. 95.1 FM, AM 1420 here locally for WIMS viewers and listeners, of course. And then, of course, you got AM 1060 and 102.5 FM. Big George, we just hung up with our guy, Mark, over at Region Rides. He was chatting about his magazine, and I just love it. Chock full. You've got great articles in there. Let's start there.
Mark's my man. I'm telling you, the guy, he really eats, sleeps, and breathes this hot rod culture, the car show, the whole high-tech and low-tech and medium-tech information system. He loves it all.
I am so about that. Let's chat a little bit about some of the stuff. You know, it's really, really important. You're all about safety, and safety from a standpoint of vehicles. Let's say cars, trucks in general. You've been doing this for 4+ decades. You're a very successful local business guy, still doing it, still doing your radio show, award-winning at that. But let's talk about what we're chatting about today on the show. And it's that black ice. It's driving safely. It's, you know, learning how to brake, and especially for our younger drivers. But let's be honest here, all of us up the chain to the wisest of years, because man, you try to stop on black ice and you might be a little fooled. You want to play with that a little bit, George, and chat?
I got to tell you, Rick, there's no substitute, absolutely zero substitute for slowing down. You got to slow down. All the anti-lock braking in the world and the traction control and the anti-skid control, there's so many great devices on your car now, but they just can't. That black ice is a treacherous. It's terrible, and it's really hard to overcome. You have to be going slow enough to begin with to get away with it. If you're going too fast, no anti-skid device in the world is going to stop you.
I agree.
Nothing's going to help you.
I agree. And, you know, we really have to allow ourselves the extra time. I mean, depending upon where you're at, Chicago, Indiana, Michigan, you know, we all know during winter times, during crazy times, and even like as Mark was mentioning, everything is turning into, a sheet of ice. And as the temperatures lower, which we're at right now, or below freezing, you've got to watch that, because you could come up to a stop. Even trying to get in here to the radio ranch today, they've plowed the streets beautifully, the county, but forget about it. It's pure ice, man. So I was literally down to about 8 miles an hour, and I still, at that point, just went slowly, creeped up to the driveway, and then just gently turned in. You got to watch it. Watch our children, please, out there at our bus stops,
Rick.
You know?
You know, if anybody that's ever seen or been in a multi-car and truck accident knows that there's no reason to hurry. There's not a reason in the world to go fast enough to cause something like that. Go slow, drive nice, and let the car's technical advances help you when they can.
I agree. All right, so we got a huge show lined up, and I know that you and Tim have done a great job. You're tweaking it all the time, not only the on-air sound, but also the sound of, you know, what's going on in and around the show, but also the look. And you guys are obviously on Facebook Live, which I love, so you could see that every week, and lots of people love viewing and commenting and calling in. 928 Car Guys. Big George will answer your calls live on the air. It's actually really cool. Chat about what's coming up this weekend, Big George.
Oh, you're going to love it. And I am so stoked. Our neighbors to the north in Michigan, up there around Knickknacks country, and specifically Detroit, are going to get a brand new $160 million plant built by the same guy that owns the Jacksonville Jaguars, that let's see what his name is, Khalid Khan. He is building a $160 million small parts plant in Detroit. Wow. 400 new jobs.
Nice.
It's going to be great. Detroit's going to get, Chrysler's doing the same thing in a suburb of Detroit. Somebody else is building in Flint. That whole area that was abandoned by the car world is coming back. They're all going to get rebuilt. They're all going to be brand new. All those towns up there that suffered when the car business bailed, or you know, went down the toilet, are coming back, and they're all going to invest here instead of somewhere else. It's really cool.
Absolutely.
I'm so excited for our friends up there.
Me too, and I think that's going to be, you know, absolutely wonderful as we roll through that. So that's on the show coming up this weekend. And if you guys have any car requests, suggestions, thoughts, maybe you want to get together, have Big George, Tim, and Mark, and a bunch of us out at your event coming up this summer. We're booking solid for our events, you know, not only rolling into this year, but into next year already. And we would love to be a part of it, whether, you know, it's a fundraiser, making a difference, and obviously we can connect with you and help you out on that as well. So give one of us a call, Ric, R-I-C, at WIMSradio.com. Big George, can you throw out your direct link and your place as well, please, to let folks know?
I have Big George, B-I-G-G-E-O USA at Comcast.net. That's my shop. That's me, Big George USA. And that's Bridge and Burnham in Lansing. I've been there 35 years. We have a website that's under construction. We also have a Facebook page. We got all that. I'm on Facebook too with Big George the Car Guy and Twitter and geez, you name it. YouTube, you guys got me everywhere. Gerard Media's got me plastered all across the country. I love it.
I absolutely love it. And I got to say good morning to our good buds over at MC Custom Interiors. Of course, John and the crew over at Blue Top, and our Region Rides crew as well. Unlimited Service. There's so many great folks that make that show happen. And each and every week, we really appreciate folks that not only listen in, chime in, call in. You know, we're all about it. It gets bigger and better every week. And just keep your eyes peeled, because we got some major announcements coming up as we roll through the next several weeks into spring and summer. So I'm really excited about that. Big George?
I got to tell you, I write that article for Region Rides, and one of my old English teachers, retired English teacher, now about 66 years old, so she's old. She actually reads that magazine. She gets it for her husband at the grocery store, because he's a car buff. And she read it, and she corrected it and sent it to me. And ever since then, now every time I write an article, I have to send it to her first.
I like.
Because she can correct it in red pencil.
Can I tell you something? There's nothing wrong with that. It makes you feel young, and God bless her for being there and still having it, you know, all together to help you out, because it's all about helping out, you know?
Her and the hubby, I guess, go to all the local car shows. He's a car nut. She goes with him.
Good.
It's got to be fun when you get, I'm older now. I'm 66, and I still go to all of them. I love them.
You know what? It's only age is only a number. You just keep that smile, keep that energy flowing, and thanks for all that you do, Big George.
Oh, I love it. I just love it. And you guys make it easy over there, IMS and HFB, and my God, all the other contacts we have. We're just doing great.
Thanks, bud. Appreciate it. Have a wonderful day. Safe travel, okay?
You too, man. Thank you.
AM 1420 WIMS Michigan City, a Gerard Media Company, streaming live at WIMSradio.com.